Okay, so you've finished your flat sketch and now you need a CAD. You need to be able to add color and pattern, possibly, into your sketches, and you need to do it quickly and easily. Well, that's what today's tutorial is all about. So, before we get going, if you're new to the channel or you haven't already, please take a moment to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell. And that will notify you each week when we post a new video. Okay, let's get started.
The technique I'm going to show you is an updated modern method in which you use a tool called Shape Builder. Traditionally, when designers would create a flat sketch, you'd have to create a separate shape for each object you needed to fill with color. You're watching me draw with that technique right now. This is still a method that many designers use to sketch, and it still works. However, it's more time consuming. And with today's super fast deadlines, you need to be able to execute your sketches pretty quickly. So you want to use a sketching method that's speedy and efficient. Plus, when you're sketching a garment, most people are not thinking about drawing in shapes. You're just trying to draw your design. Using a more modern method allows you to sketch your designs in a much more intuitive way. And what I love about the Shape Builder tool is that its job is to create shapes, which means I don't have to. All I need to worry about is drawing the design in Illustrator. And really, that's all you should have to worry about. To add color in Illustrator, you must have closed shapes. So to create your closed shapes, select all of the solid lines that form the boundaries of the shapes you want to create. Let me say that one again. Select all of the solid lines that form the boundaries of the shapes you want to create. Usually that means you're selecting all of your solid lines, and what you are not selecting are your stitch lines. You definitely want to make sure you don't include those, as well as any extras like wrinkle lines or brushes. And if you happen to have selected a line you didn't want, press and hold the Shift key and click on those lines to deselect them. Next, double-click the Shape Builder tool, and when the Tool Options box appears, click the box next to Gap Detection to turn it on. Now, I have a whole other video on the Shape Builder tool and why it's so awesome, and I'll add a link to it below so you can check it out after you finish watching this video, of course. But what I do want to say now is that the Gap Detection option is a game changer, so you want to make sure you turn this feature on. And once you do, press OK and bring your cursor over the shapes in your sketch. You'll begin to see a grid texture in each area, which is where Illustrator is identifying your shapes. And to actually create the shapes, all you need to do is click in each area. You can even add color while you're using the Shape Builder. This tool has really cut my sketching and CADding time in half, and I get my work done a lot more quickly. And all the quick tips and tricks you can use to recolor your sketches will still work and will also help you color up your designs quick, fast, and in a hurry. So that is this week's digital fashion tutorial. Hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to hit the like button if you found this helpful and subscribe if you want to see more digital fashion tips like this one with me, Mikkel, your digital fashion guru. Have an awesome day and I'll see you on 7th Avenue.